Hey, my name is Sam Sansalone, and I'm a real estate agent in Hampton Roads, Virginia. And today we're talking about the pros and cons of living in Chesapeake, Virginia. Now, if you've seen my pros and cons videos about Virginia Beach and Norfolk, I put one of them up here, and you compare those cities to Chesapeake, you're gonna find that there's a vast difference. And just like what I did with Norfolk, where I took the city and divided it into the two separate sections, I'm doing the same thing in Chesapeake. Chesapeake takes that concept and blows it up. That it would do you an injustice if I just did a broad pros and cons for the entire city, because each section's different. I'm going to show you the different large pieces of Chesapeake and tell pros and cons of each of those sections. And after each section, I'll also give you a restaurant that I recommend you try in each of those parts of town. So looking at the map, there are four different sections of town. Number one is Western Branch on the far west side of the city. And number two is Deep Creek. Number three is South Norfolk. Yes, Norfolk. Number four is South Chesapeake, or the Greenbrier, Grape Ridge, Hickory area. So when someone asks me what I think about Chesapeake, my initial response is, well, what part? Number one, Western Branch. As you look at the map, you're gonna find that it's far west and actually borders Suffolk on the west side and the north side, and on the east is Portsmouth. Now, the cons to Western Branch. So number one con is location and proximity to Virginia Beach. It's just a long drive. If you work in Virginia Beach, if you work in Norfolk, if you work even in the south part of Chesapeake, you're driving at least 20 to 25 minutes to get to the far west side of any of those areas. Sometimes upwards of close to 45 minutes to an hour, depending on traffic. There's not one real thing in Western Branch that would scare anybody away other than the drive time to the rest of the south side. That leads me to the next con, which is there's not a whole lot to do. But it does not mean that you're gonna be out at 10:30 at night living the high life. If you don't go to Western Branch, you are missing the action. No one's saying that. If you do like to enjoy yourself in the evenings or go see an event, you're not gonna be staying in Western Branch to do that. Now, there's some pros to living in Western Branch. Now, one of the pros is real estate prices in relation to what you get. You can pick other parts of Hampton Roads that have better almost everything, but there's not a whole lot that Western Branch is missing. So you're getting a decent balance of a lot of good variables. You're getting decent schools, you're getting a nice, comfortable family setting, and the prices aren't very high to get there. There are some pretty good school districts in Western Branch.
As you can see here, Neats.com has Western Branch as the number 16 best public high school in Norfolk area, which includes the south side and the peninsula. That's of 53 public schools total. It's a solid school. I'd say there are a few schools that are ranked higher in Chesapeake, but of those schools, I'd say Western Branch definitely holds its own.
Another pro is you're close to other areas of growth. Now, you're bordering Suffolk, which is a growing part of town. Now, the north side of Suffolk has a lot of new stores, lots of new developments. It's becoming a great family-oriented area, and you're close to that. You're also close to Newport News and Hampton. If you want to drive from the south side to the peninsula, you're not too far away from access to that part of town as well. And there are a lot of family-oriented areas in Western Branch. You don't have to go too far to find neighborhoods that are low crime and very family-friendly. Now, another part of Western Branch is the amount of shopping there is for being on that part of town. The reason I say it that way is that a lot of parts of the western side of the south side area are so spread out that it's hard to find a lot of great shopping. Western Branch has lots of stores, grocery stores, Best Buy, movie theaters, the mall. There are a lot of options for your shopping needs, and you don't have to drive very far. It's a very central location if you're on the west part of the south side. Now, the restaurant in Western Branch that I recommend you try is Mediterranean Roots. Now, the address is down below. It's actually in Chesapeake Square Mall, which is the big mall in Western Branch. People are raving about the falafel and the baklava. It's a relatively new restaurant. Now, number two is Deep Creek. Why did I say it like that? Deep Creek is probably about 20 minutes from Virginia Beach, Norfolk area. Now, the first con being in Deep Creek is the crime. Just like in any parts of Chesapeake, in any parts of the area, just because I say crime doesn't mean that the whole area is full of crime, but there are more pockets of higher crime in Deep Creek. And number two, there's not a lot to do in Deep Creek. Your nightlife will probably be spent mostly in Norfolk and Virginia Beach. There are a lot of industrial areas in Deep Creek. There are more older homes in Deep Creek. Just kind of an older part of town. Nothing against it, it just has that older feel that some people just don't really value. Now, a pro to living in Deep Creek is that the real estate prices are more affordable than Western Branch or going further into South Chesapeake. So some people will come here because they want to buy a house and then commute to other parts of town. And so people will come here often to find that balance. They don't want to drive too far away, but they also don't want to spend too much for real estate. So often they'll move to Deep Creek and then commute somewhere else. Honestly, other than that, there aren't a lot of things to talk about with Deep Creek. Primarily, you're going there because of the real estate prices. It's just a little bit cheaper living there than commuting to other parts of town. Here's the place in Deep Creek I'll recommend for a restaurant is the Barbecue Shack. It's right off George Washington Highway. I'll show you the address down below. It's actually really awesome. People rave about this place, one of the best barbecue places in town, but it actually is like basically a shack. But don't let that fool you, it's the real deal. Now, number three is South Norfolk. Okay, well, Sam, this is a video about Chesapeake. Why are you talking about Norfolk? I'm not. South Norfolk is actually part of Chesapeake. In 1963, South Norfolk merged with Norfolk County to form what we now know as Chesapeake. Now, the cons in South Norfolk are the crime. It's known to be an area that if you talk about South Norfolk, a lot of people associate crime with it. Not every part of South Norfolk has this issue, but there are a lot of pockets, and I'll show you again the map so you can see. There are lots of areas in South Norfolk that have this issue. As you can also see that there are plenty of places in and around South Norfolk that are very, very low crime. South Norfolk has a connotation for having high crime. It's all about context, right? I would say look at each individual situation case by case before you make a decision about whether or not South Norfolk is a great place to be for you. Now, another con is the school district. This is not a place that has highly rated school districts in any part of South Norfolk. So if you're moving to South Norfolk, keep in mind that that is a factor. And if you're going private school or homeschooling, this might not be as big of a deal for you, but this is something to keep in mind. The other con is, once again, see a theme here, no activities. There's not a whole lot else going on in South Norfolk either. You're still driving to downtown Norfolk and you're still driving to Virginia Beach. Now, while you're closer to those places than you are in Deep Creek and Western Branch, you're still having to leave your part of town in order to go to those spots. And the same goes with shopping. There's a lack of shopping in South Norfolk. The further you drive east, the more options you have. And the lack of amount of grocery stores, department stores, all that, that's not the place to find those things. Now, there are some pros to living in South Norfolk also, though. One is your proximity to Norfolk. You're like 8 to 10 minutes away from Norfolk oftentimes. You're just one interstate road up to downtown Norfolk and you're there. So you can get much more affordable real estate in South Norfolk and have a quick access to Norfolk if that's where you work. Another pro about South Norfolk is its history. Because of when most of the homes were built, they were built in the early 1900s, so it has that Victorian style. In addition to that, the Jordan Bridge was a bridge that was decades old before it got torn down and was rebuilt to be one of the higher bridges in the state of Virginia. It's a cool looking bridge. It's 1.5 miles each way, and so it's a great one to run on. I actually run on this bridge. Another pro is the real estate prices. You can get a great value in South Norfolk in pockets of areas that you feel comfortable in and have a reasonable commute to downtown Norfolk or Virginia Beach. It's generally the cheapest real estate in Chesapeake. Now, the restaurant I recommend in South Norfolk is Taco Fiesta. The address is down below. Another small, locally owned place. I love those kind of locally owned places. Some of the best tacos you'll ever eat. Now, the last piece of Chesapeake I'm talking about today is also the most in demand, which is South Chesapeake. Hickory, Greenbrier, Great Bridge, Cedar. It's basically like a Virginia Beach where it's got a lot of large pieces of property, a lot of parks, can be rural, have a lot of access to sporting facilities, training, schools, lots of factors that help develop kids and help make a very family-friendly environment. Now, another pro to parts of that area in Chesapeake is its relation to Virginia Beach and to Norfolk. It's not as close to Norfolk as South Norfolk is, but it's probably about a 20-minute drive to the major parts of Virginia Beach and major parts of Norfolk. Like the Greenbrier area of Chesapeake, it's only about 10 or 15 minutes from Virginia Beach and Norfolk. Number two is a great place to raise a family. Wallethub actually ranked Chesapeake in the top 50 of best cities to raise a family. And there's actually a website called Credit Donkey that ranked Chesapeake as the number one city to raise a family in the state of Virginia. Another pro is low crime. This goes back to the family element. Very low crime in most of Chesapeake, South Chesapeake. You'll see if you zoom in on my map on Trulia, the crime map, the crime statistics are so low, you see almost nothing in that south area. You see nothing over there? There's nothing there. So it's very low crime, very comfortable for families to settle. Another pro, a lot of good restaurants, much more than other parts of Chesapeake. You've got Greenbrier, Cedar Road, and Great Bridge. They're all kind of a cluster that make a place where if you don't like certain restaurants in one area, you can drive and find some more in others. A lot of them are mom and pop, which is also nice, especially as you go further down south. Now, another pro is the shopping. Same goes with the restaurants. Thankfully, with a lot of good restaurants goes a lot of good shopping, especially in the Greenbrier area. That area keeps developing. More restaurants are coming in, more buildings are being built. Dollar Tree is building up more of their headquarters in that part of town. Battlefield Boulevard, the further south you go, you're gonna see more places that pop up like Greenbrier. You have the Home Depots, Lowe's, all the big box stores. It's a place where a lot of people go to live and to shop. Then the biggest pro really is awesome schools. Grassfield, Great Bridge, Hickory, the three biggest and best. Grassfield is very highly ranked. There are a couple others that are highly ranked too. If you're coming to South Chesapeake in this part of town, you're often coming here for the school district. There are a lot of pros, but in all those pros, it equals the con, which is it's highly priced to live here. The real estate prices are much higher. You're paying much more for the same house in Greenbrier and Great Bridge as you would in Western Branch and other parts of Chesapeake. You get a mixture of country and city. So as the city grew, it grew around the framework of that country vibe that already was there. So you get the country feel and the city feel, but then growth came in the 80s, 90s, 2000s. And then when that happened, more houses got built, bigger houses got built. And so a lot of people that are willing to spend the money will get a lot of house in South Chesapeake, but they're also gonna pay a lot for it. And the other con is boring. I've talked to all kinds of people, a bunch of friends of mine, clients, and they all say the same thing. Nightlife is nothing. There's nothing going on in South Chesapeake. You gotta go to Norfolk, gotta go to Virginia Beach, but it's the same that goes with the rest of Chesapeake as well. Go on TripAdvisor and do a search in Chesapeake for things to do. You're gonna find a nice list, but most of them aren't in Chesapeake. So they had to pull things from other cities to fill the list. The top six things in Chesapeake on TripAdvisor are farms, parks, and trails. That's it. You're not moving to Chesapeake because you think it's New York. You're going to Chesapeake because you more than likely want to raise a family or want somewhere that is comfortable and within reasonable access to other places. Now, there are plenty of restaurants I could recommend in this area of Chesapeake, but the one I'm recommending now, Burrito Perdido. Another real small spot. It actually shares a gas station on Cedar Road. I'll show you the address down below. It's amazing. It is known for not having a can opener. Everything's fresh. It's the biggest, most tasty burrito I've had. It compares with Chipotle. It's one of the best burritos in town. If you got anything out of this video, take this away. Every piece of Chesapeake is different. You can go into Great Bridge and find a spot that you really don't like. You can go into South Norfolk and find a place that you love. So when someone gives you advice as to don't live in Chesapeake or you gotta be in Chesapeake, it's all about context. What part they're talking about, what neighborhood they're talking about, what specific street often they're talking about. Another bonus con I wanna mention about most of the areas of Chesapeake are the sneaky tolls. And the reason I say sneaky tolls are because since Chesapeake is such a large part of the area, there are certain spots in Chesapeake that you have to pay to get through to other cities. So the main key to know is that with every place where there is a toll, there's probably another alternative route to bypass that toll that might take an extra few minutes, but might be worth the savings. If you like this video, if you've been watching for a while, hey, I'd love it if you subscribe. You can hit the subscribe button on the bottom right-hand corner of the screen here. Hit that bell too, and that'll notify you every time I do a video, which is every Wednesday. You are part of the family. It would mean a lot to me if you subscribed to my channel.